Well, hello everybody and welcome back to Farthest Frontier, the City of Rhi. So, last video, we got a bunch of stuff done, and we need to get the people back in the guard towers. We were just attacked not too long ago, but raid frequencies can be a little odd. So let's get everyone moving about. We got our third 12x24, and we got ourselves a proper crop rotation of... I should probably go to here. So one of the fields is doing flax and beans, the other ones are just doing clover beans, but clovers and wheat. And turnips, clover, peas, each of them alternating so that in any given year, all three of these are yielding. Pretty easy thing to do. And we have three windmills, and this will process about 1,000 wheat each. So we're probably yielding about 5,000 to 6,000 per year. So we'll need some of it to go towards cattle, and then other parts of it will just be kept for excess. And we'll just kind of play it by ear. We got 10 out of 10 over here. We got 450 milk, which is being turned into 450 cheese, 430 cheese per year. I think that actually the two worker here doing 430 is pretty good. I don't really think an extra worker is worth the 20 cheese. And we're making some meat, some pelts, all that stuff. We have two boar farms now, one on the north and one on the south side. And you can see that the boars are really bringing this stuff in. And because of that, I guarantee without even looking that I'm going to need to get another smoker. Nice, I can put the smoker right there. I'm gonna move this smoker right here. Let's see, is this guy getting negatives from anything? It's possible that he is, but I just can't see. I don't think he is, though. When I set everything up, there's nothing. Yeah, he's good. He just doesn't have a whole lot around him. That's okay. He's just not important. But yeah, we got a lot going on for us right now. We've got a big... This clay pit's about to go out. Only 320 left, but we got our other clay pit over here going. I think actually what I'll start doing is putting this to max. And we'll just wait till this is depleted. I know that was a lot of workers, but at the same time I have some big dreams. Big dreams. We need more stone, for sure. Got to get more roads. Dream big. Okay, 250. Yeah, let's upgrade this guy too. Got ourselves our vault over here. Storing all the money. You want to make sure that no money is being stored in your warehouses, because like 1,000 gold can take up a whole warehouse and weight. Vaults are very important for when you start making money. We also got all our towers up here. We have still a few more to go, but we're at plus 60. Yeah, we're doing pretty dang decent. I do actually kind of want to get the last market area up. I think it would just be kind of good for us to push it. Honestly, the easiest way to line it up is just to use parallels. So we'll just use this over here, and we'll just do parallels. I don't know why I'm making this so hard on myself. I didn't need a count or anything. This is about 12 or so, or 13 over. So we'll put the market there. We just need a little bit of stone. All right. Yeah, there's really not a whole lot of stone in this map. I primarily buy most of my stone. Okay, we're going into another winter. I'm going to get rid of all the guards. And we're going to get rid of all the farmers. Oop, probably shouldn't have done that, but I did it anyway. Woo! Yeah, everything should be harvested, so cool. There we are. And one of the things that happens, now we have rats. We finally got rats, so I gotta start dealing with that. But we have a two-tile gap issue going on here, so... Okay, we're gonna have a rat catcher per market. Seems to be the best way to do it. I don't do rat catchers on the storehouses because I don't have a lot of food, but in this design, it probably makes sense to have a rat catcher in this area. Since it's all really close together, actually, it's really actually a good design. But we'll do all that, get those rat catchers going up. That's gonna be a big cost, but a necessary cost. How many builders do we have? 28 maximum. All right. Yeah, we're gonna run out of people real fast. No coal. All right, we're burning through too much coal. I'm gonna have to pump the glass making down so that we don't burn through our coal so quickly. And I might just pump this down a little bit for now so we can build up some more coal. All right. So, realistically, I might actually not even need that rat catcher in the middle there. So we can move that. We want to make sure we get all the big stuff. Perfect. Yeah, we don't need this guy. I'm gonna just cancel him. We'll be able to do it with just the market rats. That's another actually good thing about this design, is it really does hit all the areas pretty well. It's kind of weird how the rat stuff doesn't work. I would really take a lot of the gameplay with a grain of salt until we see 9.2, because I think 9.2 is going to be a lot closer to what we should be anticipating as the final mechanics. And they'll definitely be cleaning things up during testing, so. Pretty darn good. Yeah, we want to get rid of the rats because we do not want a plague outbreak. It's the last thing we need right now. Okay. All right, so like I said, just do this parallel. So this lines up here. As you can see, it's right here. Oops, went over. Oh, boom. Okay, that makes more sense. And we're going to get all the houses up so we can get our gold up. And so that we can finish this inner area. Alright, we're doing it. And remember last video I got these guys with flour. But I'm trying to not do too many set limits on anything because it causes so many issues with the movement and stuff. We definitely want 2 people per baker. Okay. So we'll make bread. Get ourselves a good food. Alright, it's the beginning of the year. Need to put all our farmers back. And we need to put all of our guards back because I think something big is coming. Nice, we got 71 stone with all our guys out there doing that stuff. Pretty good. Oh, shh. Bears are... Oh, no. Sorry. Where the freak? Got 2 hunters over here for 4s. I got a forager. Yeah, the bears are kind of dicks, man. I need to, need to get some stuff going here. We need to get some towers down here, I think. Let's get some northern towers. Kind of deal with these bear situations, because we got this bear and he's just kind of chilling. I feel like this can be easily taken care of. Yeah, these people are really stupid. They just like run right out of the bear. But this is why you need to get the fencing up around your village, and I also why I need to get towers up. Okay. This is exactly why you need to get towers up though as soon as you possibly can in your areas. So let's start making some good decisions here. Oh, whoopsie daisy. Yep, that's right. Yeah, we're just gonna bust up a ton of towers. Probably need to be a little bit more conservative here, though. All right, we're gonna send out the guards. Pop 2 guards into here, and we'll just magically get more people somehow. We're making enough pelts now that I can start selling them. I think we'll find out if I'm wrong. We got an enormous amount of wheat, though. I might try taverns out in this design. I know I usually don't do taverns, but we'll see. We shall see. I might make some alcohol. Or if maybe I won't do taverns, but I'll probably make alcohol with the excess grain I have. It's not a bad idea to do that for trade, at least. Yeah, but you can see we definitely have an abundance of what we need for the rats. Cool. Perfect. All right, cool. So everybody's covered now. All right, let's go kill a bear. All right, we're gonna kill this freaking bear though. There he is. Kill him. Well, freaking torment us no longer, bear. Bear was a dick. Auto refill is back on. Put this down to 18 workers. We need to make sure filling out. All right, let's get some money. We definitely have a lot of clay. I think we can actually start even selling pottery. Perfect. All right, 161 shirts. Boom, boom, boom. Ooh, 507 a cow. If I needed cows, that would be a good deal. Alright. Got a good chunk of change now. That's good. We're also going to start getting a lot of good stuff coming in. So make sure no raw meat stored. Bump that up. What is our spoilage rate? 1,502. 10 people. Yikes. 1,000. Okay. Yeah, they're having to haul it quite a distance, but at the same time, keeping it close to where the firewood is for me has been kind of like what I'd like to do, but been the most efficient that I've been able to find. Kind of hard to have. I'm keeping it near the cows and stuff like that. Nice. More shirts. What's he got? Play. Yeah, I still have not found a temple relic that I want. They all cost money, and I think the only one I want right now really is the one that does extra crossbow damage. We are making crossbows finally. Over here, make it 7 a year. That's pretty good. Might have to get another one of those guys up. 15 shirts just is not a good deal for me. I'm gonna buy the stone at 9. Now I know that seems rather extreme, but because I have the ability to get my money back, I think it's worth it. I really do like to have upgraded roads for that efficiency boost and movement speed. So, makes me feel good. And we're definitely gonna want all the efficiency boosts we can get. Alright, time to go crazy. Yeah, it's gonna be a little wonky, but feeling good about it. Right. The decoration will go here, and then the wells will go where the wells want to go. Probably here, and there. Go, and then outside of that will be the fencing. Go. That will hopefully keep some of the bears out. We want to make sure we have access points for them to get out. Just randomly wherever we can. That will just help to some of the stuff in order. Here we are. Oh, I want that enabled. Sorry. Cool. And look at that. Perfect. That will give us a big influx of money, too. Beautiful. And we'll want a rat catcher over here for the next area. Eventually, I think this next rat catcher will just kind of take the whole area there. That. Beautiful houses and money. Yeah, we're doing pretty decent now. I would really like to get the rest of this upgraded. I need 500, so. Drops. Oof, that's a lot of beans. A lot of beans. We'll be okay, though. We do seem to be kind of hitting our stride. We don't have a lot of meat spoiling, that's good. Barely any fruit spoiling, that's good. We actually don't have too much spoilage, that's interesting. We got a lot of room for growth. I'm thinking, like I said, that this will easily go to like the fives when I'm done, definitely. Let's make sure everything over here makes sense. Are we still making baskets? Cool. Soap. I think we could boot that up. I think we have enough tallow now. Let's definitely upgrade all of these guys. Why do I have rats here? Oof. Messed up. Here we go. Mine is out of ore. Perfect. Get rid of this. It's a lot of people back in the workforce. Manually get rid of them. Auto refill. Get the farmers out there. Boot this up to 28, 38 maybe. Let's get everything. Yeah, let's get everything built up. Winters are a good time to micromanage a little bit. 295. Give me sad. I think I'm gonna upgrade this guy. 500. Yeah, let's do it. Let's have a nice shrine. We got money. More money into the coffers. Ooh, yeah. Get this guy up. Alright, so I'm winging it. We definitely want to get this guy up, though. I'm pretty sure that the entertainment, the theater can do a lot, but realistically, this stuff is really valuable. Either gonna go here. Yeah, we can always move this stuff around too, so. Put the house. Oh, yeah, that doesn't really do me too much. Probably would have been better here, but we'll put it here anyway. I feel like whatever towers I put in the corner are really not gonna do well, but, I'm gonna put them in the corner. Get some real defenses now. We got all our corners done. Our double tower on the inside. Oh, no. Double gates on the inside for extra protection against raiders. That way, if they bust one wall, they can't just go willy-nilly. They gotta break through multiple gates to get to each tower. While they're getting shot from back here. These towers definitely need two people in them. We got some money. I really want to upgrade some of these towers, actually. I know it's going to cost... It cost goes up from 5 to 12 monthly costs, but the bonus to increase damage kind of seems worth it. Wow, man, we are just plowing through our cash reserves, though. I better hold off before I go too crazy. Nice. All right, cool. So now we can do this. And then the next guy, I'll try to figure some finagle something so I can get this guy over here. Yeah, I could probably do something. There we go. No rats. Get another hospital over here somewhere. There we go. Now we got it. At least we got like some protection from this tower over here. I should probably upgrade all the corner towers so that they can shoot out further. But nice. We can get rid of this bear now. Boom. And then once the rest of the fencing is up, we'll be in good shape. Crap. There we go. That's why I don't like to micromanage, though. I always get distracted by all the stuff that's going on. Nice, 7,000. Yeah, alcohol production actually might make some sense right now. I don't know if I'll do a tavern, but maybe I will do alcohol production. I usually shy away from it because it doesn't really sell for too much more than the honey, and I prefer using the wheat for other things, but because they nerfed windmills so hard, it's just kind of a pain in the ass. I could build more windmills, but, yeah, maybe we'll do taverns, I don't know. I guess everybody getting drunk isn't too bad, but it just causes so many production issues. I just need to find, it's been so long since I've done brewing, so. Oh wow, yeah, it doesn't even have a negative. Place it right next to a house. Not bad. I'll definitely want to put a well right next to it too. To make it that much easier for them to do. Put it right next to all the wheat, where the wheat's stored. And the honey stored pretty much in there. And that reminds me, I need to make sure that there are entryways for the market area. There we go. Perfect. Nice. Ooh, 9 per. No, not nice. And we're 339. Okay, okay. Need a little bit of coal, so I'm gonna buy it. Keep things, keep the wheels greased, buy some clubs. Swords, if I see swords for really cheap, I will buy them. I think I actually, yeah, it looks like our wood is, oof. Everything seems to be a little off now, actually. Probably need to get another firewood splitter. Alright, whatever. I'm just gonna put it right here. I might want to move this stuff over one so I can get this road lined up correctly. We're gonna need to start getting this area ready. Perfect. Get that upgraded. Now they have a, now this is the herb area, so I don't want to do too many crazy things here. But I do want to make it easier for my guys to get to work. Oh my gosh, that is a huge immigration wave. Look at the conga line of people. I will take every one of them. Nice, look at all that. I might start doing some more candles. Not bad. Yes. Oh, this is one I actually want. Luxury goods lasting 20% longer. This is my favorite one, actually. 9 per iron. That's actually a good rate to buy iron at. I can't afford it, unfortunately, though. But that is one I want. I'll start looking for some free relics, but fortunately, I haven't found anything yet. I need to send this man. This man right here has been chosen. Name is Arahan, and 37. He is a herder. He's herding these cows. Oh, look at that. He's already my favorite person because this is one of the most important things, having access to infinite stone. Funny enough, I don't have a bunch of walls in this build, though, so it's not as important. Oh, infinite iron. Yeah, this whole area over here is definitely going to be utilized. It's not too far from the people if I do stone roads. And, wow, infinite sand. It's a little far away, but if you have the people, that's worth it. Most likely, it's actually cheaper to buy the sand and probably buy the ore. But the stone is very valuable because stone is hard to come by. Got some more herbs down here. It's not bad. This is the edge of the map, though. Oh, fuck me. You're gonna have to fight. You're gonna have to fight for your freedom. You were close, man. You were close. That wasn't enough. All right. So we got this dude. Get the next market up. We're just getting all the markets up in this episode. We're gonna get some progress here. That way we can at least just know where we stand. Get the wells up. Oh, okay, we're there. So now we just need to finish the freaking fence. All right, where did I bring the fence last episode? Right here. I have no idea. I have no idea where the fence starts or ends. Okay. There's only one thing you can do in a situation like this. Bring it in until it's green. There we go. Once we get this stupid fence completed, then the bears won't be able to eat us anymore. This is not such a stupid fence. It's a very good fence. Alright, and we're just gonna put little outs randomly. Cool. Our bear food days are slightly over. And this awful, awful road really depressing me. There we go. That makes a lot more sense. Alright, boot this up to 2 people and upgrade it so it's efficient. The boards, I think we were declining in boards because of all the upgrades that were requiring boards, so I think we're in good shape now. Yeah, so the corners really aren't enough. Really isn't enough. We can put anything we want in these corners later. Ooh, that reminds me. Get this park up right here. Gonna hit almost everything and we'll get another park up over there. Yes, we'll just move this over here. Oh wow. Look at that. They did it. I need to move this. Okay. We need to move a couple things. Alright, forget this forager shack. We don't need the berries from it anymore. And, this guy can go here. This guy can go... Yeah, he can go. Oh, no, he might. We might want to keep him in the distance somewhere. Let's just move him here for now. Need to move this over. Plus 64. Dang, man. We're raking in money now. But we're probably gonna get hit by a big raid. We're getting soft. I need to make sure that there's 2 people in every tower. Except for that tower. That tower is doomed. These towers are both doomed. Nice. 1 tile down. Cool. We'll move him 1 tile down, then I can get the rest of this fence done. Okay, I'm doing it. Let's upgrade this tower. And let's upgrade this tower over here. Corner tower. Closing corner towers. Probably would have been better to upgrade these corner towers. Let's do it all. Let's go crazy. Let's have some standards. Because we're gonna get money. Throwing it all in. Cool. Yeah, plus 4, that's a good one too. You can also get relics from fighting. We really should be getting raided any second now, to be honest. It's been a while. But every time you destroy a camp, it reduces the timer. That's the thing. So Vanquisher actually isn't as hard as it used to be once you start destroying those guys. Cool. There we go. Fully fenced in. Yeah, let's upgrade one of these. We can't. We don't have stone. There we go, finally. Waiting forever for you guys. 76. That's not that bad. Our defense is actually kind of suck right now, though. Cool. 2 of the towers didn't get upgraded, but these guys did. And they're getting plus 8s and 7s, and they got people with crossbows. And they got a much wider shot. Alright, yeah, they're going to break the fences, which is the one thing I hate the most. Cool. See, they tore down a ton of fencing. Such a hassle. Alright, cool. I guess that wasn't a ton. They're a little confused. That's actually kind of funny. Alright, I'm trying to see what they're doing. See if we have any weaknesses. But so far, they're ignoring most of the buildings. Because the towers are engaging them. So they're trying to figure out the best way in. And they're a little... They're like running around like rats. It's kind of cool, actually. Alright, yeah. Stone is definitely where it's at. You can get... Just an absurd amount. They really buffed it in the last patch. It has a much higher defensive value. But yeah, the corner towers are doing their thing. I do like these upgraded towers because they're able to shoot into the next layer pretty well. They did destroy one of the corner towers. Eventually, though, this whole thing is just going to be lined with towers. Upgraded towers up here. And they're not going to be able to do much. Got a soldier out there. Alright. Yeah, so far so good. I mean, they're kicking a little ass, but... Guy just, like, breaks into a random Random spot, okay. But yeah, now you can see why I don't like fencing, because it's like, I'm gonna have to go around the whole perimeter of my base, fixing every stupid fence they break. They just need a repair all button. That would be, like, honestly, I'm gonna suggest it. Just like, please make a repair all button. All right, there we are. Pause the game real quick. If anyone's selling stone, I will take it. I'm actually gonna sell these shirts because I'm hard up for cash. No, I would buy that iron, but I don't need it yet. Mostly I need stone. Well, we just got raided. So the good thing about when you get raided that you know you don't need these guys for a little bit. Except in the areas where you're farming boars. Yeah, still the same dude. Alright, villagers raided. Killed one person, we killed 61 out of 76. Alright, max of 466 population. Yeah, tier 4 is coming next. A lot of these guys over here are doing pretty well. We haven't even started the fireworks show over here yet. That's a lot of stone and boards, so we just don't have it. But I could, like I said, I could definitely get a lot of gold just from having the houses. Each one is 2 gold with an upgraded market. That will get us pretty high. There we go. Got upgraded corner towers now. This is a pretty beefy area in here. The barracks are kind of a letdown. Towers are where it's at. What a show. Alright, well that's going to be the end of this Let's Play. We've got a lot, I mean we got a ton done. Look at everything we got accomplished. Thank you guys so much for watching and have a great day.